Hi everyone, it's Heidi again. If you are new, welcome to my channel. If you're not new, welcome back. Today we're going to be reacting to a video about tipping culture. It's called Why Tipping is So Out of Control in the US. I've been dying to react to this one for a while now. It was put out by the CNBC about a year ago, so I'm interested to see if some of those things are still accurate. I'm betting they are. I don't think that tipping culture has gotten any better since a year ago. And now that I've been out of the country and I've been able to experience a not really tipping culture versus the US, I have a lot more thoughts about it. So I'm really interested to see what they have to say, and I'll give whatever insight I have. I want to know what you guys think as well. If you like the video, make sure to like and subscribe, and let's do this.
When was the last time you purchased something and you weren't asked for a tip? Yeah, I can't remember either.
At least if you're in the United States. I'll have to think about that. Probably when I was in Europe, to be honest.
Culture has gotten out of control. I get up to the pay window and she's like, how much do you want to tip? What am I going to tip you for? I'm in the drive-thru. Oh my God.
Tips have been on the rise for decades. During the 1950s, people commonly tipped 10% of the bill. By the 1970s and 1980s, that jumped to 15%. Today, people tip anywhere from 15 to 25%. According to one 2022 survey, consumers said they tipped more than 21% on average.
Nowadays, 21%. I'm trying to remember. There's kind of a rule of thumb where it's like if you pay less than 15%, it's either 15% or 20%. If you live in the United States and know this rule, let me know. But I've heard it from servers that are friends of mine or family, or from just people talking about the topic or teaching other people about the etiquette of tipping, where there's this social obligation, right? That if you tip less than that, then you're like a terrible person or you're being rude. It's seen here as there's almost a social obligation that citizens of the United States will put on each other, that it's only courteous to pay whatever that amount is, that it's our responsibility and the courteous thing to do, and that if you don't, you're like being ungrateful or hurtful towards the server, instead of talking about how maybe the employer is the problem and the idea of the culture that employers don't have to pay their employees a living wage. That's not what we're concerned about. That's not what people are concerned about here. It's whether the customers are helping pay their wages. It's honestly insane. Anyway, let's continue.
There are people who argue 20% is kind of a cheap tip.
While the percentage that consumers are tipping at full-service restaurants in the past couple of years has remained about the same, in the fourth quarter of 2022, the number of tips provided at full-service restaurants grew 17%. Meanwhile, the tip frequency at quick-service restaurants such as coffee shops and fast food chains rose 16% during the same time period.
What we're seeing now nationwide is something that is known as tipflation. At every opportunity, we're being presented with a tablet that's asking us how much we'd like to tip.
In many cases, not only replacing the old-fashioned tip jars that you could feel good about throwing some spare change into, but actually suggesting tip amounts.
Okay, I really like the way that they put that. I love when there's like a tip jar, and if people want to tip, they can. It's not this, like we're seeing on the screen, add a tip, you want to... Will you give us a tip? Especially, I can understand tipping when it's somebody who's actually waiting on you. And even this is a little bit crazy, but if we are going to accept some kind of tipping, having a server who brings your food to you, asks if you need anything, is there to help you during your eating experience, I can understand tipping for that, especially if they do a really good job. I mean, I've wanted to tip people because they do such a good job of serving, you know, when I'm in a restaurant. When it starts to become an obligation, or when you start to feel guilty not tipping, when someone's just standing at a counter taking your order, and then you take your food and walk away, that's what's so weird to me. Like when I go to an ice cream parlor and they just put my ice cream on a cone, or they put my ice cream together and hand it to me. What am I tipping you for? For doing your job? I figured you do that already. So this kind of stuff is so weird. The most awkward and uncomfortable thing about it is that you make your selection. If you hit no tip, they turn that thing around and they can see that you've hit no tip. They can see that you've consciously decided not to tip them and have rejected them. And it's really weird because some people will, when you do decide to tip, they'll say, oh, thank you for the tip. Like, you know that they know. When it's really something that a tip is really not necessary.
Often, right in front of the employee receiving that tip. Not
exactly.
To mention also your dinner date and the dozen or so people standing behind you in line.
And yep. It's gone beyond just the tablets. The other day I was using the Hopper app to book a hotel, and it wasn't until I confirmed my payment that I realized my hotel was $10 more expensive. It turns out, Hopper assumed I wanted to add a tip, and I had to go back to a prior page in order to opt out.
Tipflation refers to not just that we're tipping more, but we're tipping everyone for everything.
Everywhere.
You're being guilted into tipping on something that is not technically a service. It's someone simply doing their job.
Exactly. I'm agreeing with everything that they're saying in this video so far. Going back to that Hopper tip, there are, and they'll probably talk about this, there are lots of situations now where there is a required tip. It is just part of the payment and there's nothing you can do about it. She talked about that in that particular situation, she could go back and opt out. That's not always the case. Sometimes you're just forced to tip, and at that point, it's not even a tip anymore. It's a fee. Why are we still calling it a tip when it's required? That kind of, that bothers me so much.
In those situations, consumers are feeling resentful. Where do you draw the line?
What? Are we feeling resentful about this? I don't seem resentful, do I, guys? Yes, that's 100% true.
TIP stands for To Ensure Promptness. Tipping may go back as far as the Roman era, but according to most experts, the practice likely has its origins in medieval Europe.
Noblemen take...
Okay, hold on. I didn't know that that's what it stood for. Did you guys ever know that? To ensure... Shoot.
Stands for...
My brain just like blew. I can't even remember what it was now. To ensure promptness. That's interesting. To make sure that your service is being done in a timely manner. You learn something new every day.
Or to ensure promptness. Tipping may go back as far as the Roman era, but according to most experts, the practice likely has its origins in medieval Europe.
Noblemen taking passage on roads would throw coins to the rubble to ensure safe passage. One theory is that it evolved in eating and drinking establishments as a way to forestall envy, that when you're eating and drinking, you're having fun, and the people who are serving you are not.
Fast forward to the 19th century.
That's
when waiters who received a full wage went on strike demanding higher wages, they were replaced with women who employers could pay less. A decade later, there was the population of newly freed slaves. The idea from these restaurant owners was that they were giving the luxury or privilege of a white person's tips. That was, without a full wage.
Ironically, as tipping exploded in the United States, it became less common in Europe and was replaced with service charges.
While the first federal minimum wage law was passed in 1938, it wasn't until almost three decades later when the tip minimum wage was established. In 1991, the federal minimum wage for tipped employees was set at $2.13, which is what it remains at as of March 2023.
As far as
it hasn't been risen at all. What? Is it still the same in 2024? Oh my gosh, it's ridiculous. I mean, when people say, oh, the US runs on modern day slavery, they're being quite literal. That's exactly where it started. It is really interesting to see the different reasons why people would tip. I can understand tipping in advance to try and get something a little extra, or yeah, to ensure promptness or something like that. But that doesn't mean that it's a guarantee. So that was kind of interesting. It's really mind blowing that we haven't updated that in 30 years, more than 30 years. Fascinating.
I know the United States is the only country that exempts tipped workers from having to receive the full minimum wage.
In 43 states, it is legal to pay tipped workers less than the standard minimum wage, because tips presumably make up that difference.
Okay, so in case they don't talk about this, I do know that there are some places, I don't know if it's state regulated or if it's what restaurants decide to do, but I do know that some restaurants, and I think it's fairly common, they'll have a regulation where if servers don't have enough tips to at least reach minimum wage for the area, then the employers will compensate for that and kind of make up for the difference. But I know that not everybody does that, and that was fascinating to see how many states just don't require that. They're just fine with not paying their servers. What the heck? And then citizens get mad at each other for not tipping properly. Like, can we not see where the problem actually is? I do want to say that I've seen several debates on Twitter specifically talking about this and people just ripping into each other for not tipping 20% or not leaving a tip or something like that. The employer is never, ever mentioned. Why? That's just the social obligation that we've all grown up with. Blech! Hopefully we can talk about this and make it a little less normal to people.
In recent years, you might have found yourself asking, do I tip this barista for pouring that hot coffee? What about when I'm going to a restaurant and picking up takeout? And how much do I tip that doorman, driver, or dog walker?
When those in the service industry were feeling the brunt during the coronavirus pandemic, consumers started tipping for things they never had before. And the percentage of remote transactions when tipping was an option in which the consumer tipped soared from about 46% before the pandemic to around 86% in January 2022. If people were willing to tip the person delivering food to their home 30%, why not ask if they'd like to tip when they come pick up?
During the pandemic, businesses who lost a lot of traditional customers and transactions were looking for alternative ways to make up that income. And if asking for tips was one way to do it, they were willing to try it.
And since
I didn't think about the pandemic affecting tipping so much, I can definitely see why it's gotten so crazy in the last few years. Because yeah, when you don't have customers coming in and actually having your employees serve the customer, that makes sense. But I also can see how, why are we tipping and giving a delivery fee? Wouldn't that just kind of be the same thing? That's something that I probably need to think about a little bit more. Interesting.
Then, that ask hasn't dissipated. Another reason consumers say they feel pressured to tip more? They're being asked to tip prior to service completion.
Asking for a tip beforehand is almost like a bribe, right? It's, I'm afraid not to tip because, well, you do less good work.
Customers might not be concerned about the barista's perception of their tip before getting their latte, but what about the mechanic repairing your car? I don't know about you, but I'm certainly going to make sure to tip them well to ensure my safety.
Oh my gosh, that's so crazy. That's insane. Having a fear of not tipping, just in case that person screws you over, decides that, oh, they didn't give a tip, I'm gonna ruin their lives. What the fuck? How has the United States gotten to this spot? Oh, that makes me so mad. I've experienced that with delivery drivers when I order a meal, like through Uber Eats or Grubhub or something like that. It has happened where if you don't leave a tip before the service is even done, they won't take your order. Where the driver will accept the order, but then they'll see that there's no tip and they'll drop it and they'll let somebody else take it. And so you might go through three or four different drivers before somebody finally decides, okay, I'll take this one, even though there's no tip on it. That's not a tip anymore. That's an obligation. That's a requirement. And it's wrong.
Another reason consumers are tipping more, newer technologies. Kiosks and tablets with three large tipping suggestions that pop up on the screen in front of you. Three options chosen by the business.
I have not yet been to the restaurant where they recommend 5, 10, or 15% for quick takeout. 15. It normally always starts at 15 as a bare minimum, sometimes even starting at 20, 25, and up to 30.
According to a 2022 creditcards.com survey, 22% of respondents said when they're presented with various suggested tip amounts, they feel pressured to tip more than they normally would.
They use those options as an indication of kind of what the normative range is and feel compelled to tip within that range. So the more you ask, the more you get.
Mm-hmm. The three prominent companies with that trendy, sleek look are Square, Toast, and Clover. They launched a bit more than a decade ago to help businesses run smarter, faster, and easier, all in one point of sale or POS systems. In some cases, fewer fees so it's less of a burden to accept multiple credit cards, no long-term contracts, and multiple other useful tools, including inventory and employee management.
They got credit card processing into the hands of individuals and very small merchants. Square did a great job. It's been a tremendous growth story. That's half of the business today.
Do you think these companies are responsible for this turn of events that we've seen with tipping?
I would say they could take some of the credit for helping restaurants gather more tips.
Robert Sanchez manages Eli's Essentials in New York City.
Interesting.
One of the business's locations uses Toast, while the other uses this. He says the storefront that uses Toast sees more and higher tips.
The Clover, Square, and Toast terminals to a consumer are very easy to use. Big buttons.
Yeah, they're user-friendly.
Tip. An easy way to tip a different amount if you don't like the starting at 20% option.
Sorry, just really quickly. Look how awkward this is. They're holding it right in front of you. You are looking into the eyes of the person that you're tipping or not tipping. Yeah, you're going to feel some kind of pressure of like, oh, I feel kind of bad, but no tip. You know, I'm proud of this person for not tipping. I do have to be honest. Since I've learned a little bit more about this, when it comes to servers at a restaurant and they're coming to my table and stuff, yeah, I'll leave a tip. I still do that. But when it comes to coffee shops, ice cream places, places where you only talk to the person for a couple of seconds, I don't leave tips anymore for that. I don't. I went and found my own stuff. I brought it to you and I'm just here to pay for it. You didn't do any kind of service for me besides showing me the screen. Thank you. So maybe the more we talk about this, the more people realize, oh, you know, that doesn't really make sense. Maybe people will feel less obligated and less guilty for not tipping. Anyway, continuing.
Option. There are others that do it. They're just not as cool looking.
We've come a long way from being able to just throw your spare change into the jar by the cash register.
The new tablets have turned what used to be a sin of omission, I simply didn't put money into the tip jar, into a sin of commission. I have to hit a button and say no tip. I have to actively choose not to tip. Whereas before, mm-hmm. not tipping was a kind of a passive thing.
Glancing mm-hmm. at the tip jar could have also been a way to get a sense of how many others are tipping on that service and maybe even how much money. Meanwhile, not only can the tipping options be customized, but the tipping feature can be disabled as well. So it's the merchant's choice to ask or not to ask for tips.
From the business side, it makes employees want to perform better and do a better job.
It's seriously significant. It really pays for the software. You'd be a foolish business owner not to install it based on what the numbers display. Even a...
Okay, I can see what he's saying, where having tipping as an active option makes employees, you know, want to perform better. But at the same time, wouldn't being paid well also make them want to do a good job? I can definitely see tipping being an option if a customer really appreciated somebody's help or if an employee really stood out to somebody. But to feel like you have to do a good job or be over the top and extra, which is also a thing in the United States. Servers are so, hi, can I help you? Whoa, calm down. To feel like you have to do that to earn even up to your living wage, that's where the problem is. It's just such a hard topic.
Mammoth company as large as Starbucks has decided that they need to sink or swim, and the best way for them to do that is to offer the tip screen.
Starbucks rolled out the tipping feature in stores in September 2022.
It's one thing to have a happy staff. It's another thing to have customers that are feeling resentful. I think it's a calculus that all business owners really need to make.
That's interesting.
Do you think...
Sorry, I keep pausing, but it is interesting to think about how tipping now in the United States with these kind of situations, yeah, it does make customers resentful. And I feel like if an employee does a good job and you're really appreciative of it, but then it's like, okay, are you going to tip me for what I've done for you? It's like, okay, well, I just feel like you did that just for my money, which yes, you are, but it just makes it feel like, okay, this is just another payment. It takes the, I don't know, the like humanity and human connection out of it a little bit. What do you guys think? I do want to know what you guys think about this subject. Am I completely off base or do you agree? I don't know. What are your thoughts?
I think that they're somewhat going to start seeing that they're getting lower tips because people are paying tips to so many services, or they're resentful of the act of tipping in general.
I think that's a very real danger. Servers in a sit-down restaurant. They were greatly affected during and immediately post-pandemic by restaurants doing all sorts of fees. Their tips were actually going down because consumers were saying, well, if I'm paying for the health insurance and I'm paying for inflation and I'm paying for this and I'm paying for that, enough is enough. The more you levy these line items onto consumers, guess who's being penalized? It's the one area that's still quasi-discretionary, which is the tip.
I went door to door talking with waitresses, bartenders, and baristas, and while they wanted to remain anonymous, they told me it's happening already. With inflation and being prompted for tips left and right, they say customers have already started to tip less, and sometimes not at all. A 2022 study found that 17% of Americans are tipping less because of inflation. However, 10% report tipping more. At the same time, more than half of Americans, or 60%, want to do away with tipping entirely.
It depends on if that person sees their tip as an as their responsibility. Those are the people who tip 10% more, are the people who see it as their responsibility to pay for the employee's living. Yeah, I'll just leave it at that, I guess. Because they're really giving people and understanding people who understand that if they don't tip, that person's going to get less money. Can we please make it so that they're paid enough? That the responsibility doesn't have to be on the customer? Anyway.
The extent of pandemic-influenced generosity has also gone down. 43% of consumers typically tipped servers 20% or more in 2022, compared to 56% of consumers in 2021. Meanwhile,
that
the average tip for full-service restaurants has gone down only slightly during the same time period. According to Toast, 19.6% in the fourth quarter of 2022, compared to 19.8% in 2021.
Restaurants
However,
feel
according
different.
To surveys conducted in those same years, respondents said they're tipping higher percentages, 21.2% and 18.9% respectively.
It can genuinely hurt the people who truly, truly rely on gratuities for their livelihood. I firmly believe that the tipping invasion we are experiencing right now, I think it's a net negative for society.
And with that tablet at just about every counter, no matter where you go, the question is, where's the tipping point? I'm wondering how long before I'm tipping my doctor after an annual physical. If you want to seem especially generous after an exceptional meal, you might decide to go big and tip 30%. But it's a cycle. As more people seeking to make a good impression then up their tips to 30%, maybe even 35%, what becomes a generous tip?
I have to believe tips are going to go up from where they are today. But I also think there's got to be a logical ceiling somewhere. I just don't know where it is.
Oh, very interesting. Oh. It's pretty fascinating that when they say a generous tip, a 10% tip now, here at least, is not generous anymore. A 10% tip is greedy, it's cheap, it's inconsiderate. If you think about it, shouldn't all tips be generous? It's not something that you have to, well, now it is, but in the past, it's something that you don't have to pay. It's something on top of what you've already promised to pay. And the fact that we're even judging each other on, oh, wow, you only gave a 5-10% tip. How cheap can you be, or how selfish can you be? It's just crazy that we have to pay 30% of our entire bill to have it be a generous tip. It's just going to get worse unless, I don't know, can we get something going in politics that will, like, solve this? It's so hard that I'm sure that restaurants and businesses are feeling the pressure as well. Where do we start to fix that problem? I'm interested to see what you guys have to say about this, especially anybody in the United States. Like, are you feeling that there's something wrong with this? Because a lot of people on Twitter and people that I talk to, they still think that tipping is the obligation and that that's the way to go. It's a social contract is what I've heard it called before. Do you guys see that there's like, that this might not be the best direction? It might not be the best way of doing things? Let me know in the comments. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. This was very fascinating and a little bit heated for me. I will see you in the next video. Bye guys.